before fly fishing, man, I was helping build houses and concrete, you know. I used to make enough to eat, but I couldn't get enough to build my house and move on, you know.
Do you think you'll be a fishing guy the rest of your life? I mean,
I want to be 88, 90 years old with a like under my arm, you know, like, hey, Tom, Parman over there, sir. Lamp and bell. That's my dream, though. Till I die, brother. Fly fishing, but you can't beat that. That's the bomb, brother. I just get up in the morning, you know, get my lunch pack, pack my flies, my boots, my rain jacket, and my truck. Head out to fish, you know, like 5:45, 6 in the morning, you know. Hitting a little bit of tea or something, you know, just waiting on the hour. My name is Rankin Lester Coleman Jackson. Long name, but I'm originally from here, mangrove, you know. Born and raised right here. Grow up. Become fly fishing, tell you guys show up, man. You know what I mean? So that was a big, big change of life. You know what I mean? Big opportunity. So thank the Lord, you guys here, you know what I mean? To be in the water is an option that a lot of people doesn't have. And I love it.
This is crab mud. This is mud from the crab dig from the earth. Way down, maybe a feet under the earth. They dig it out and we pick it up from the soft part of it and we just set it up there, you know, in a little bundle. And like a day and a half or two, it gets hard, really, really hard, like cement.
My town that I grew up in is called Lordy's Bite, and it's really small little town. It ain't nothing big, and there's not much, but there's no stores at all, you know, no electricity, no concrete road. People are really poor and we survive on, you know, just what we do. You know, I'm getting ready for a new start of a beginning of a new season, you know, so I'm actually not fishing this week at all, pretty much. I just got one day of fishing because I'm working really hard on my boat and trying to get that going. As you can look over this side over here, you can see my boat is right there just getting rebuilt. I'm putting a new deck in and building a brand new platform onto that, you know. I'm trying to make it really strong and pretty good for this new season, you know. I would prefer a lot of times being fishing right now than being into that because, yeah, you know, it's a good job and it's fun, but it's not nothing like fishing. It's way more fun out there fishing, you know.
We got a couple of salvo wheels, man, to save our life. Water for the hangover. One or two frescas, one or two cokes to mix the drinks. Now we ready to rip some lip, brother. Yeah, we going to look apartment right now, man. That's the plan. And hopefully we luck enough, you know, we hit it, man. That'll be the bomb, man. Yeah. It will be awesome to grab that tail, you know, and beautiful fish.
You got a permit before?
Sarah.
Yeah.
There's a good energy, man. My legs be shaking, you know. Smartest fish in the ocean. But he's a tide guy, you know, he moves with the tide, man. If you're there in the perfect tide, you're gonna see Parmit. You're gonna, you know, I don't know, I can't tell you're gonna catch him, but surely you're gonna see him, you know.
Sometime I go like for a week, full week fishing Parmit and don't catch one. So it's really tough. You gotta have what it takes to catch a Parmit.
Of funny foe who bit my wings and ate them whole. You left before I come to. You left before I come to. We took the heels and
man, it feels great, you know. It feels awesome. Clients are happy, I'm happy. It's nice to hold that big fish in your hand. And know that that little fish, you know, he's so small and he looks so normal. No, just a common fish in that ocean, but then when clients catch him, he's a big, like, some. He's a treasure, you know, from the ocean, man. It's nice.
All right, buddy, you're free, man. That's all we want, a few photos and a little run, huh?
Years back, here in Guanaja, people didn't know what a Parmit was. His name here is a Pampa Jack, you know? And a Pampa Jack, he was one of the meals for our dinner table. For those kids to see that what we're doing is just catching the fish, releasing him, and they're not gonna kill him because they wanna see us catch him and release him. So they're protecting it also. First, we didn't do that, you know. You catch a Parmit on your hook, there's a dinner, boys. You know, they feed his family, boy, for 2 days, I don't know, depend what size the fish are, you know. But anyhow, we don't do that today.
We have a very intense hurricane, certainly one of the most powerful ones we've ever seen in the Atlantic Basin this late in the year anyway, and not very many other hurricanes have ever been out there this much stronger.
Hurricane Mitch was a disaster here, dog. Everything in our town was beautiful. Everything was spanking, everything was mellow. It was more jobs. You had hotels wrong. We used to fish, hand line fish to take to the hotel. Everything was beautiful. And we heard about this hurricane was coming, and nobody, you know, this is a normal hurricane. That's gonna pass, it's not gonna be 40 mile wind, you take it.
The winds now have been increased to 180 miles per hour. That makes it a very dangerous Category 5 hurricane.
Man, that morning when we woke up, we looked to the north. It was black.
I was home. It was just starting to hit when the tide started coming up, and we had to move out the house. We couldn't get no clothes, not anything. I just was a suit of clothes. I was all 3 days in a big house, you know, just sitting there waiting for the tide to get down low, the wind go down for us to come out.
Red. Everything was like, if you take a match and burn fire through it, everything was flat. It wasn't one single green leaf on the ground.
Mitch destroyed almost 90-95% of all our mangroves in all the Pine Hills.
Our job is, you know, fishing. That's our life. We fishing from time it was kindergarten with our great ancestors and great grandfather. And our passion is in the fishery. So if we can't get the mangroves back, you know, where the fish goes in and have their eggs, they not got no home. Because this is their home.
We had to bring back our mangroves. That is the basic ingredient that gonna give us hope.
If we don't do it, the fishery is gonna be, you know, a pain in the ass. You know, it's slowly coming back because we're trying to get some mangroves back and trying to get it the right way how it used to be first.
I got like 2 miles or 2 days there from where I was just, you know, raised up in a little town, and you know, it's pretty cool. I'm really lucky with that. So I look out for both of them, you know. And I also help other people too, like, you know, if I see this guy, you know, he's or a family who's really down, man, you can't like even buy a sword, you know, I'm like, hey man, you know, take these $5 or $10, and you know, I'm always helping everybody, so. And you know, I don't think about just myself, so that's why I really need a job, you know.
Yeah, I can't imagine how cool it is, man, to be a fly fisherman.
You go through the canal and you look at all the mangroves there, it's like a dream coming true, you know. It's like hope is really coming back, you know. You see crabs, you can see fishes, small lobsters, small shrimps, and you say, one day all this is gonna be in the sea, you know. And we're still gonna have boonfish, we're still gonna have permits.
Protecting these mangroves, you know, it helps protect our future, you know, and our kids' future, you know, because this is the one's going to be next after us, and the fish would always be there once we got those mangroves there. So that's the key, man. That's the bottom line, brother.
It's fishing, you know, it's what I grew up on, and I still live on it, and I don't feel about it. Don't feel bad about it. I feel good. I've been growing up into it, and being more as a man and growing everything, And as far as it goes, I'm hoping to do it if it's possible all my life. Doesn't matter. I love it.
I gotta train my two boys also, you know. I got my rod right here in my house. I stand out there in the front of my house and we cast without no fly. Yes. I get them into that sport also. They love it. They're fishermen too, you know. They got it in the blood. I just gotta give them the rod more often, you know. But yeah, man, it's been a privilege and a blast to have you guys in the house, you know. And hopefully, do stop coming. You know, is the town, the island, love to see you guys with that rod and that boat, into those fish. Love to see you guys burying that little mangrove. That tomorrow, day after, he gonna have some leaves out, you know. So they appreciate that. They're like, what? Somebody's gonna come and plant mangroves in our, and they open their eyes, you know, to see you take a fish, take a picture, probably measure him, release him. It's the bomb.